Good morning, students. Today we'll continue chapter 4, that is light. In previous class you have learned about types of mirror, lateral inversion and uses of plane mirror. Today you will learn about speed of light, primary color, formation of secondary color, complementary colors in composition of white light. So the first is speed of light. Speed of light, the speed of light through vacuum is 3.4 meters per second, and in air speed of light is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. Okay, so in water the speed of light is 2.25 × 10⁸ meters per second. In alcohol the speed of light is 2.20 × 10⁸ meters per second. In kerosene it is 2.7 × 10⁸ meters per second, and in glass the speed of light is 1.8 × 10⁸ meters per second. Next, primary color. The colors red, green and blue, we also call it RGB. Red, green and blue are called primary color. Why? Because they cannot meet by mixing other colors. Apart from these three colors, there are many colors in nature, and we can make them by mixing two or more color in a definite proportion, but we cannot make the primary colors. So the primary colors, that is red, green and blue. So that's why red, green, blue we call it as primary color. And when the light of red, green and blue colors are mixed, it will produce white, as you can see here. Okay, so when you mix red, green and blue, it will produce white color. Next, formation of secondary color by color addition. So what is secondary color? The color produced by mixing any two primary colors are called secondary or composite colors. As you can see, these are the primary colors and these are secondary colors. Okay, so here red, if you mix red and green color, here I am talking about color of light. Okay, here red color of light and green color of light, if you mix red color of light and green color of light, that will produce yellow. Here I am not talking about paint colors. Okay, here I am talking about the color of light. So when you mix red color of light and green color of light, that will produce yellow color. And when you mix blue color of light and green color of light, it will produce cyan color. And when you mix red color of light and blue color of light, that will produce magenta color. So these are the secondary color. Secondary color means the color produced by mixing any two primary colors are called secondary color. We also call it as composite colors. Okay, so next we have complementary colors. So what is the definition? A pair of colors which on mixing produce white color are called complementary color. For example, if you mix green color of light and magenta color of light, it will produce white color. So here we can say green color and magenta color complementary to each other. Similarly, blue color light and green color light, if you mix blue color of light and green blue color of light and yellow color of light, that will produce white color. So here blue and yellow colors complementary to each other, like that green and cyan green and cyan color produce white color. So green and cyan color are complementary to each other. Next, color of an object based on reflection and absorption. Do you know, students, why white look white and green look green, red look red and black look black? Do you know the reason? The reason is reflection and absorption of different colors by the object. Now you understand. So here the first case is when light falls on the object. When a white light fall on the object. So let's say this is a white color of paper. Here white color falls on this white paper. White colors means white color is composition of seven colors. Okay, so all colors falls on this white sheet of paper and gets reflected all color. As you can see, all colors get reflected back. Okay, so the object appears white because all colors recombine to give white light. Because any object which is white color, which is in white color, never absorb any light. The condition is the object should be non-luminous opaque. Okay. Next, here this one is a, let's say this one is a black sheet of paper, and here a white light falls on this paper. Okay, but no colors get reflected back. So that's why the object looks like black, because no color gets reflected back, and any object which is black color always absorb all colors of white light. Okay, so that's the reason the black look black. Next one, let's say this is a red color of paper. Okay, so here when colors of white light falls on this paper, all colors except red get absorbed by this paper. As you can see, only red colors get reflected. Okay, only red colors get reflected. That's why red look red. Clear? Next, when color light fall on the object. So the first situation is when a white color object is seen in a color light. So here what will happen? When a color light fall on a white object, it does not absorb any light and the light is reflected back. That is the property of white color. Okay, any object which is in white color never absorb any light, any color of light. So well, for example, let's say for example, a white rose appears red in red light and blue in blue light, because when red colors falls on the white rose, the red colors get reflected back. Okay, because that is the properties of white color, and white color never absorb any color, all colors gets reflected back. So that's why when the red color falls on the rose looks like red rose, and when blue colors of light falls on the white rose, the rose looks like blue color. Clear? when a color object is seen in the same color light. Okay, now what will happen? When a color object is seen in the same color light, it appears to be the same color. It's the same color is reflected back. So red rudge in red light appears red. Clear? Next one is when a color object is seen in a different color. Okay, so when a color lights fall on a different color object, the objects appear black because no light is reflected from it. For example, a red rudge when seen in blue light, that will appear as black color. Okay. So now we'll understand about color subtraction. Color subtraction means subtraction means to reflect or color subtraction means to reflect or absorb a particular color of light in the presence of the other colors of light. For example, a shirt is made, that is the definition of color subtraction. Okay, for example, a shirt is made of a material that is capable of absorb green light. Here let's say this is a shirt. Okay, and the properties of this shirt is it can absorb green light. Okay, now white colors falls on this shirt. So as you can see, red, green and blue color falls on this shirt, and the property of this shirt is it can absorb green color. So this shirt will absorb green color. Now only two colors, that is green, red and blue, gets reflected back. Okay, so now the appearance of this shirt will be magenta, because this white colors falls on this subject, and the properties of this shirt is absorb green color. So white minus green. Okay, so white color is what? Red plus blue plus green minus green. So green will be cancelled here, and red plus green is magenta. Here primary colors red plus green, wait, red plus blue equal to magenta. Okay, next. So if cyan light fall on it, it appears blue. Now you'll see how. So cyan colors, this one, blue plus green, blue and green color falls on this subject, on this shirt. Okay, so when blue color and green color, the combination of blue color and green color is what? Cyan color. Okay, and the property of this shirt is it will absorb green color. Okay, so only blue colors reflected back. So the appearance of this shirt will be blue, because cyan color falls on this subject, cyan color falls on this shirt, and this shirt will absorb green color. So cyan minus green color, and cyan color is the combination of blue and green. Okay, so blue and green minus green will be cancelled. So only blue color is left. That is the appearance of this shirt. Clear? Next is composition of white light. As I told you, composition of white light is what? Composition of seven color, that is violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. Okay, so this band of seven colors is called spectrum, and in spectrum the colors are seen colors are seen in the reverse order, that is red at the top. As you can see, this is the prism, okay, and here white colors get reflected back, and white colors falls on this prism, and all seven colors can be seen here. And in this spectrum, red color at the top, as you can see, red color at the top and violet at the bottom. Clear? Next, formation of rainbow. So when just after a rainfall, a large number of water drops remain suspended in the air, and when and these droplets act like tiny prism. These water droplets these water droplets act like tiny prism, and when sunlight passes through these droplets, the white light splits into the seven constituent color, as you can see here. This is the properties of a prism. Okay, so water droplets, when a white color falls on or passes sunlight, when sunlight passes through these water droplets, white light split into the seven constituent colors. Okay, so with a large number of water droplets contributing to this phenomena, we get to see a huge continuous band of seven color displayed in the sky, display in the sky in the form of rainbow. So that is the formation of rainbow. Okay, so this was for today. Thank you, students. Have a great day.